Hello students, welcome to the new lecture. And in this lecture we are going to discuss about the kidneys. Okay, kidneys, internal structure of the kidney and structure of nephron. So now we are going to start with the first topic, that is the kidney. And human beings have the pair of bean shaped reddish brown structures. Okay, it means the kidney structure is a bean shape. And if you see, the bean shape is looking like this and it is a reddish brown. It means on the outside you can see the reddish brown structure. And in the previous lecture we have discussed about lab activity and how you can see the structure of the kidney with the help of a goat kidney or sheep kidney. Okay, so these kidneys are attached to the dorsal wall. Okay, dorsal means on the back side. On the dorsal wall these kidneys are attached and into the abdominal cavity, and each kidney is placed on the other sides of the vertebral column. Let us consider this is the vertebral column. On either sides you can see the kidneys, and these kidneys one kidney is slightly lower than the other kidney, that is right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney, so that there is a liver. Due to the presence of the liver above the right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney. And here, coming to the size of the kidney, is 10 centimeters in length. Its length is 10 centimeters. Its breadth is 5 to 6 centimeters and 4 centimeters in the thickness. So these are the measurements of the kidney. And each kidney has a convex on the outer side and concave in the inner side. What is meant by convex? If you see here, the kidney shape in this way. Okay, the kidney shape is in this way. And this is the convex. So this is the convex and this is the concave. Okay. So this is a concave and this is a convex, this is a concave. So hence, as a result, we can see the both convex and concave shapes in the kidney. And inner side of each kidney, it has a fissure. So can you see here the fissure? And we will see now here. So this is the kidney and here this is the fissure. Okay, the fissure. So the fissure is nothing but the region where the tubes and also ureter is coming out. So what are those tubes? One, those tubes are nothing but the renal artery and also renal vein. So the renal artery, renal vein and ureter, these are the three tubes that are coming out of the renal fissure. Okay, so next, the inner side of the each kidney has a fissure. You can call the fissure as a hilum also. For the entry of the renal artery, it means the renal artery is going to enter into the renal fissure, and while the renal vein is going to exit out, it means the renal vein is coming out of the kidney and also ureter is also coming out. It means how many tubes are going into the kidney? Only one tube is going into the renal fissure, that is known as renal artery. Okay, what is the tubes that are going to come out? There are two tubes, that is the renal vein and also ureter. Renal vein and ureter, these are the two tubes that are coming out of the kidney from the renal fissure. Okay, so what is meant by renal vein? Renal vein and renal artery. So the term renal refers to the kidney. Okay, a renal artery means it is a blood vessel that is related to the kidney, is known as renal artery. So what is meant by renal vein? Renal vein means the blood vessel which is related to the kidney, that is known as renal vein. We know that the vein is nothing but it is a blood vessel. It is going to carry the deoxygenated blood. Okay, and artery is going to bring the oxygenated blood. Here the function of the renal artery is the blood vessel that brings oxygenated blood with waste material. Okay, from the heart. Okay, from the heart the blood is brought to the kidneys. Okay, so in which form? So it is in the blood is in the oxygenated form plus waste materials. Oxygen and also waste materials will be brought to the kidneys. So here the kidneys are going to purify the blood. Okay, the oxygen is utilized by the kidneys and the waste materials which is present in the blood will be purified by the kidneys. Okay, and same way the renal vein. So we have seen the renal vein is going to move out of the renal fissure or exit the renal fissure. So while exiting from the renal fissure, this renal vein is going to carry the deoxygenated blood. Why the blood is turned into deoxygenated? Why? Because the oxygen is utilized by the kidney, hence the oxygenated blood will be converted into deoxygenated blood. okay. And also now we can see the purified, the blood is purified. Why the blood is purified? The waste materials in the blood is taken by the kidneys, and also the blood is purified by the kidneys so that the blood will get purified, okay. So next, the ureter. So the ureter means a tube that carries the urine from the kidneys to the urinary bladder. Here you can see the ureter. This ureter is coming out of the renal fissure, and this ureter is going to carry the urine from the kidneys to the urinary bladder. What is urinary bladder? It is a bag like structure or a sac like structure which will hold the urine up to some extent in the body, okay. So this is about it. So renal artery, renal vein, and also ureter, okay. So next, this is the internal structure of the kidney. If you slice the kidney from the vertical section, okay, if you slice the kidney from the top to bottom section, you can see in this structure. So the kidney structure has different parts. So in this lecture, we have to remember the main important things like the renal pyramid, okay. Here this is the renal pyramid. You can see here, this is a roughly pyramid like structure. This is known as the renal pyramid. And also here you can see a small lines. Can you see the small lines in the renal pyramid? So these small lines are nothing but the nephrons, okay. You can see the nephron in the renal pyramid, and after a moment we will see the real structure of the nephron. It means the maximized structure of the nephron. So remember, the renal pyramid has the nephrons. So let us consider this is the renal pyramid, okay. So this is the renal pyramid, and this renal pyramid has the lines, okay. The lines which are present in the cortex and in the middle. This is the cortex, okay, and this is the medulla, okay. So as a result, what will happen? These nephrons are running from the cortex to the medulla. So as a result, you can see there is a important function in the filtration, and these nephrons has a supply of the blood. You can see here, this is the renal artery. The red color is the renal artery, and this blue color the thing is known as the renal vein. So this blood also coming, let us draw the structure in the larger shape, okay. So this is the pyramid, okay. So renal pyramid, and these are the nephrons, okay. So these are the nephrons. These nephrons has the blood supply, okay. The blood supply, this is the artery. So this artery is going, the renal artery is going to come and also supply the blood to the these nephrons and so on. Hence, the again from these nephrons, the waste materials will be removed, and the again they are going to form into vein, renal vein. So the renal artery is going to come, supply blood to the nephrons. The nephrons will filter the blood again. The renal artery will turn into renal vein and exit, so on. We will discuss about the structure in detail after a moment, okay. Remember, the renal pyramid has the nephrons, okay. And also we have to remember the renal pelvis also. Here this is the renal pelvis, okay. This is the renal pelvis and ureter, okay. Now move to the main topic, that is known as internal structure of the kidney. So the kidney has two distinct regions, like a cortex. So this is the cortex, this is the cortex, and inside is the medulla, okay. So this cortex is a dark colored outer zone, that is known as cortex, and inner side, that is known as medulla. This medulla is pale colored inner zone. It means it has a little bit brightness, little bit less brightness, that is known as medulla. So each kidney has made up of, it means each kidney has how many nephrons? The nephrons range may be 1.3 to 1.8 million nephrons, or approximately it has more than 1 million nephrons are there, okay. So the nephrons are also known as uriniferous tubules. So because they are going to filter the blood and also help in the production of the urine. And these nephrons are microscopic. Microscopic means you cannot see with the help of eyes, okay. You need microscope to see the nephrons which is present in the kidney, okay. They are present in the kidney and also having the tubular function. Next is the structure of the nephron. Just now we have seen these are the small lines like structure are known as nephrons. They are present in the renal pyramid, okay. Now we will see how these lines are looking and how the nephron is looking like. So this is a nephron structure, and before discussing the nephron, we will discuss a few terms, the few important terms. So the each nephron has a two parts, that is a Malpighian body, renal tubule. So here the Malpighian body, it has a Bowman's capsule and also glomerulus, And Bowman's capsule, it is a blind cup-shaped structure in the nephron. It is accommodates the glomerulus. Now we will see what is a Bowman's what is meant by Malpighian body. So this is the structure of the nephron. Can you see here? This is the renal pyramid. Okay, it is looking like a renal pyramid. Okay, so it is looking like a renal pyramid, and the nephron, half of the nephron is outside and half of the nephron is inside. So this is the boundary zone. This is the boundary zone of the renal pyramid. Okay, so this is the structure of the nephron. Just now we have seen in the renal pyramid we have drawn the line. Okay, so this half of the nephron is outside and half of the nephron is inside. Okay, so this is now this is the main reason for showing the diagram. So here you can see the renal artery is going to bring the blood, and the structure of the nephron is in this way. The nephron has the Bowman's capsule. It has a Bowman's capsule. This Bowman's capsule, here is a Bowman's capsule, and Bowman's capsule has the glomerulus. Okay, glomerulus. Okay, so what is meant by glomerulus? It is a network. It is a network of the blood vessel. So here, this Malpighian body, the Malpighian body, MB means Malpighian body. It contains Bowman's capsule. Okay, Bowman's capsule plus glomerulus. Okay. Bowman's capsule and also glomerulus. This Bowman's capsule, it's a blind cup shaped structure. It is looking like a blind cup like structure. Okay, so next we will move to the next topic, that is known as glomerulus, a bunch of fine blood capillaries. Here you can see the blood capillaries. So the blood capillaries over here, or you can see the blood capillaries. So these are the blood capillaries. It is also known as glomerulus. Okay, so next, the Malpighian capsule, it is also known as a renal capsule. So what is meant by Malpighian capsule? It is nothing but the combination of the Bowman's capsule and also glomerulus. So Bowman's capsule is looking like cup like structure, and also glomerulus is nothing but a blood capillaries, or is fine blood like fine network of the blood like structure, or blood vessel like structure, that is known as glomerulus. Okay, so this is about Malpighian capsule. Malpighian capsule means Bowman's capsule plus glomerulus. Okay, it is also known as Bowman's Malpighian capsule. Malpighian capsule or Bowman's capsule is the same. Okay, so next is the afferent arteriole. So the afferent arteriole, it is a broader blood vessel. If you see here, there is a broader blood vessels like afferent arteriole. This afferent arteriole entering into the Bowman's capsule. Okay, so this afferent arteriole is the starting point. This is the afferent arteriole. It is the ending point of the this glomerulus. So this afferent arteriole will come. This afferent arteriole will form this glomerulus, and this glomerulus will exit out. And this exit point is known as afferent arteriole. It means the glomerulus is present between the afferent arteriole and also the glomerulus is present between the afferent arteriole and efferent arteriole. The both terms look like same, but you can see the small difference. Here AFFERENT and here is EFFERENT. These are the two differences that you can see in between these two terms. Okay. Now it's fine. Now the glomerulus is going to help in the filtration. How it is going to filter? The afferent arteriole is a little bit larger diameter. Okay, and this is the glomerulus. Let us consider this is the glomerulus, and this is the afferent arteriole. This is the afferent arteriole. If you see, compare the diameter over here. The diameter is large. The diameter is larger, and diameter is narrow. Okay, or you can call it as a wide. The diameter is wider in the afferent arteriole. The diameter is narrow in afferent arteriole. Why the reason? What is the reason for having such kind of a variation? So here, as a result, the blood will come into the afferent arteriole. Okay, and move through the glomerulus. So this is the glomerulus. Okay, and this is the afferent arteriole. So as a result, due to the narrow size of the afferent arteriole, there is a pressure is increased in the glomerulus. So when the pressure is increased in the glomerulus, due to the narrow nature of the afferent arteriole, there is some filtration. It means the waste materials will move out of the glomerulus, And this glomerulus, you have this glomerulus has some kind of structure. The structure is known as podocytes. Here you can see the glomerulus has the podocytes. It is lined by a single layer of the squamous epithelial cells, and the squamous epithelial cells has the fine pores. These fine pores are present, and as a result, the waste materials will move out or filtered out of the glomerulus. Here you can see this is the podocytes. So these are the cells. Okay, the cells, single layer of the cells known as squamous epithelium cells. Okay, so as a result, the blood will come into it and also move out of the podocytes, but the waste materials will move out of the podocytes. Why? Because these podocytes are made up of single layer of the squamous epithelial cells. So the squamous epithelial cells are from the due to the presence of the fine pores in the squamous epithelial cells, there is a exit of the waste materials. Okay, so where this exit of the waste materials will be seen, where they are collected? They are collected in the Bowman's capsule. Can you see here the cup shaped structure? This is the Bowman's capsule. These all the waste materials will be collected over there, and these waste materials will move into the another structure that is known as PCT. Okay, that we will discuss after a moment. Okay, so next is the afferent arteriole. It is a narrower end of the glomerulus. Because of the narrow end of the glomerulus, a pressure is exerted on the glomerulus. As usual, the waste materials will get filtered out of the glomerulus. Okay, so this is the process how the glomerulus is going to do. And now you can see here, this afferent arteriole is going to line the tube. Okay, the line the next thing that is known as renal tubule. Okay. So this renal tubule is a part of the nephron after the glomerulus. Can you see here? This is our this is the main thing that is known as the Bowman's capsule, or you can call it the Malpighian body. And after the Malpighian body, you can see a tube-like structure that is extending. Okay, this is known as Malpighian. This is known as the renal tubule. This renal tubule is surrounded by the thing is known as efferent arteriole. This efferent arteriole is going to surround the renal tubule, and this renal tubule has a two important structure, that is PCT and also DCT. Here you can see the PCT is near to the Bowman's capsule. The PCT is near to the Bowman's capsule, and the DCT is farther to the Bowman's capsule. So hence you can call it as a PCT is a proximal convoluted tubule. Okay, it is also known as the first convoluted tubule. It means near to the Bowman's capsule, which is nearer to the Bowman's capsule and is present in the cortex of the kidney. So where is the cortex? This is the cortex. Okay, near to the cortex of the kidney. Okay, so next is the distal convoluted tubule. It is also known as second convoluted tubule. It opens into a collecting tube, forms a pyramid and also calluses, and which opens into the pelvis. And in the pelvis, the ureter, all the parts of renal tubule is converted into a network of peritubular network, forms efferent arteriole, and the peritubular capillaries join to form a renal venule, eventually forms into a renal vein. Okay, in this diagram we can see, okay, this is the efferent arteriole entering into the Bowman's capsule, and in the Bowman's capsule we can see the afferent arteriole is turning into efferent arteriole. This efferent arteriole will join to form a venule. This venule will form into renal vein. Okay, this renal vein exit out of the nephron and exit out of the kidney and form and carries deoxygenated blood plus and also purified blood. Okay, so this is about the renal artery and renal vein. Okay, and next is, there are few questions given here. Why the diameter of the efferent arteriole is less than that of the efferent arteriole? That is just to apply the pressure or to exert the pressure, the diameter of the kidney, the efferent arteriole is less than that of the efferent arteriole. Okay, so in the nephron you can see, this is the Bowman's capsule. Okay, this is the glomerulus. This is the efferent arteriole. This is the efferent arteriole. So its diameter is narrower, so that there is a pressure will be increased. When the pressure is increased, there is a filtration. Okay, So next, why the nephron is considered to be the structural and functional unit of the kidney. So the nephrons remove the waste materials from the body and helps in the purification. And without the nephrons, the purification of the blood is not possible. So the nephron is considered to be the structural and functional unit of the kidney. Okay. And I hope this lecture is helpful to you. And in the next lecture, we are going to discuss about the mechanism of the urine formation, ureters, urinary bladder, and urethra. And by the way, and the link is available in the description so that you can attend the exam, okay, test of the chapter 3, okay. So the chapter 3 test is the exam for chapter 3 is available in the link which is in the description, okay. We can click on the link and it will be taken to the exam, and after the completion of the exam you click on the submit button and the result will be displayed to you, okay.